Let me demonstrate quick what we're trying to achieve as a rider. What we're trying to achieve is to get the horses back up. These reflex points I'm going to hit first is to show you how to relax the lower back muscle. And then right here where his tail is, this contracts his stomach muscle, and you see how his back will come up. And right here is another little reflex point, and you can see how he lifts his back. These are positive reflexes. This is what we're trying to achieve when we ride the horse. Of course, I could run after this horse and poke him here and there, but I can't run as fast as the horse. So let's talk about the negative reflex points, what exactly do the opposite what we just saw. In the wither muscle area here, where we got the rhombi, the spinalis, and the trapezius muscle, that is an area where we have three axes. We have the cranial nerve 11 coming right through here, and there will feed into these areas. This is an area, the wither muscle here, also known as the trapezius muscle, where the stallion over 60 million years jumps on the horse, bites the mare there. What happens is we get a signal, the nerve shoots right through the shoulder, and the horse will not go forward. What also happens is the horse will drop the back. You saw how the horse's back come up. If I gentle, you can try it at home too. Touch this area here. This doesn't hurt him, it's a reflex point. He's not sore, it's just when you touch your elbow, you will feel it all the way to your pinky. What you just saw, he dropped his back, is because that is what this nerve channels to the muscle, tight back, and then he will not go forward.
Okay.
And bring him up first. There you go. Oh, that's good. All right, so, ready? So if the stallion bites here, or the dressage saddle, or jumping saddle, or any surcingle, this reflex point here, as soon as it hits, his back drops. You see how irritated he gets? And when his back drops, it's very hard for the horse to engage. So we really need to stay away from this triangle. Other reflex points, what makes the back muscle very tight is right here. You can see how he's not sore. As a matter of fact, he has a very good muscle. It's just their little reflex points. This is between the vertebrae where all the nerve endings come out. So if your saddle hits one of those reflex points, that definitely is an area where the horse will get very tight. I wonder why he's not as good today. Oh, I forgot. I put the bigger saddle pad underneath, and now my horse all of a sudden doesn't bring his back up. Yesterday he was much better, but I didn't have the thick saddle pad on. And as we know, the big saddle pad will make the channel a little narrow. This is a very negative reflex point right here. You also saw it's not ticklish. This is what we know the bucking star. If the saddle stays or push on this star, he's already lifting his leg. This is sort of his firing leg. If I hit here, sometimes horses kick out. If the saddle sits here, the horse will not canter. We lose our beautiful 3-beat canter. We are maybe experience a 4-beat canter. Or if it's really pressing hard or past this point, the horse will actually buck just to get that pressure off that spot. So what we want to see here is the saddle support area of these axes. From this X, the gluteus medius is, and then we got the latissimus muscle. Wherever we have muscle edges, we don't want to put any excess pressure. So if we would have a jumping saddle here with short billets, we always want to girth the buckles off these edges. So we want to girth up the saddle very, very high. In other words, in the last three holes of the girth of the billets in the jumping saddle or any saddle that has short billets. Down here, we have another muscle, that's the edge of the pectoral muscle, right there. You can have every horse, if you find the edge, they actually sometimes twitch a little bit or holds himself. When your buckle hits that spot, the horse will not extend, and you wonder why he looks great in the free with lock extension. But under the saddle, he has a very short stride. It could be just a simple matter of have your buckle sitting in this area. Again, girth should be nice and high, so you should be in the last three holes of the saddle.